Hi friends, welcome back to my channel and welcome to day 18 of Vlogmas. Today will be my October and November book haul, but first of course we have to open the day 18 advent calendar present. Ooh, a tote bag, and it says, "He always thinks because I'm reading, I'm not doing anything. There is no greater plague to an introvert than the extroverted." And that is a quote from Pierce Brown. I'm thinking maybe a Red Rising quote. Yes, a Red Rising inspired tote bag. So there's no real order to the book haul I'm about to share. And I honestly don't think that this is all the books that I hauled in October and November. But these were the ones on my haul shelves. And I really don't want to go back through. I just want to get caught up on these and then move on with a clean slate moving forward. As I said, there's not a real rhyme or reason to this. I'm not going to go over what books were in this or pre-orders or that kind of thing. I'm just gonna pick up and go. The first book I hauled was Kingdom of Sea and Stone, and this is the sequel to Crown of Coral and Pearl. I'm honestly not sure what that one's about, but it is a sea-themed book, so it immediately went on my TBR. Next is A Cuban Girl's Guide to Tea and Tomorrow. In this book, we are following Lila Reyes, who has the perfect life until the trifecta happens and her life falls to ruins. Her parents are then worried about her mental health and send her on a study abroad trip. Next is Crown Chasers by Rebecca Coffendaffer. And in this, we are following Alyssa, who is next in line for the throne. However, Alyssa wants nothing to do with the throne. She wants to explore and live life to the fullest. Until one day, her uncle, who is the person on the throne, becomes gravely ill and surprises everyone by suggesting a crown chase or a competition for the crown. Alyssa is then the favorite to win because the crown chase is a scavenger hunt, and she finds herself locked in a position where she's the favorite to win the crown, even though she wants nothing to do with it, but she feels the duty to it because of her uncle. Next is A Princess for Christmas, and in this we are following a man and his little sister, and his little sister spots a princess hailing down a cab in New York. So this essentially is like totally Enchanted vibes with Amy Adams in it. It reminds me of that, but it is them taking in a princess because she seems lost in New York City, and what else would she do but join, you know, a Hallmark Christmas brother and sister to fall in love with, you know? Next is To Sleep in a Sea of Stars by Christopher Pellini. This is the same author that wrote the Inheritance Cycle or the Aragon series. In this, we are following Kira, who discovers in the first contact of alien life until her exhilaration turns into panic when the alien or dust particles begin to move. Meanwhile, Earth is on the brink of annihilation during this space war, and Kira might be the key to saving them all. Next is The Black Mage, and I don't want to go too far into the synopsis because it might give away like the entire graphic novel because they're a little bit shorter, but I do like this tagline that says, "A magic university in need of some diversity," and it looks so good, doesn't it? Next is Kingdom of the Wicked. I actually hauled two editions of this. Well, technically I hauled four, but I did unhaul two of them because I don't need four editions of the same book unless it's like incredible. I do think this will be good, but the other two editions were a little bit plain. This is the story of Amelia and Victor, who are the twin sisters hiding as witches within the human world, until one day Amelia discovers her sister's dead body and has to team up with the demon to get vengeance on who the killer is. Next is The Midnight Bargain, in which we are following a sorceress who has to balance her family duties with becoming the next great sorceress of the world. Next is Among the Beasts and Briars. In this book, we are following Ceres, who has grown up in this kingdom in which the queen has bargained with the Lady of the Wilds or something of that sort to protect the kingdom from the enchanted woods. And Ceres herself has firsthand experience with how awful these woods can be, considering it killed her mother and friends. And she has been touched with the curse of the woods her entire life. One day a new queen is crowned and the curse is set to take over the kingdom again, and Ceres must bargain with everything to save her home. Next is Master of One, in which we are following a thief who has been assigned to collect 6 Fae relics, and he's on the hunt until one time he discovers that these relics are actually people, and he is one of them, and he has to stop this person who hired him from taking over. Next is Fire Frost by Camille Longley, in which we are following a huntress and a monster who are forced to join together to make a perilous journey through the mountains. Next is Soul Swift, and as I was reading the synopsis, I think the first sentence is enough. It says, Gelia is a vessel, a girl who channels the word of the one true god through song. Yeah. Next is Lightbringer, which is the third and final book in the Furyborn trilogy. Next is Raybearer by Jordan Fuego. In this, we are following Tarasai, who is destined to join the Princess Council. And she believes that she is joining to, like, be part of the council. And the person who is having her join has other plans. They want her to kill the prince. Next is Spoiler Alert, and I'm pretty sure that this is a Hollywood star / fanfic author and a cosplayer get together. Next is The Once and Future Witches, and this one looks so good that I don't even want to go into the synopsis, but it's a gorgeous and thrilling pay-in to the ferocious power of women. There's no such thing as witches, but there will be. And again, it looks so good, I don't even want to go into the synopsis too much. Next is my Lit Joy edition of Pride and Prejudice. I have A Deadly Education by Naomi Novik, a school in which you either graduate or you die. I got 2 editions of The Lives of Saints, a short story collection within the Grishaverse. Next is Storm the Earth by Rebecca Kim Wells. This is the sequel to Shatter the Sky, in which we are following a girl who steals a dragon to rescue her girlfriend. Next is the Blaze Wrath games. This one looks so good, and it is pitched as How to Train Your Dragon meets the World Cup. Next is the Camelot Betrayal by Kirsten White. This is a sequel to the Guinevere Deception, which is a gender bent sort of King Arthur retelling in which we are actually following Guinevere and her story. Next is A Golden Fury, in which we are following a female alchemist who is trying to live up to her mother, who was a very famous alchemist. Next is a collector's edition of Shadow and Bone, the first book in the Shadow and Bone trilogy, or the Grishaverse. Next is Legendborn, a gender-bent King Arthur contemporary retelling, in which we are following a girl whose mother has died, and she is faced with something from her past. A secret society tries to erase her memories, but instead accidentally bring powers out within her. Next is a V.E. Schwab, The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue. This is the Forbidden Planet edition, so it's got the blue sprayed edges and the blue cover, and again, I don't think I need to go into the synopsis of this one, but it is Addie, who has made a deal to live forever. In exchange, she has been forgotten by everyone she's ever met, until one day she meets Henry at the bookstore. Next is Jo, an adaptation of Little Women, and this is actually just a graphic novel, and it's exactly what it says it is. Next is Diana and the Island of No Return, a middle grade Wonder Woman novel. And the final book is These Violent Delights by Chloe Gong, which is a retelling of Romeo and Juliet. Hi friends, I'm going to film the movie night unboxing now. This is a swap created by Darling Disney Divas, and I will list all the participants down below as always. And let's go ahead and open this. The goal of this swap was to swap one movie and some snacks. So the first thing I'm pulling out is the card. It is a Sleeping Beauty card, and it says, Megan, I love this movie I chose for you. It is such a good one. I hope you enjoy it. Merry Christmas. Ashley from Ashley's Grotto. So here is what the box looks like. Let's go ahead. All right. Ooh, okay, so we got some cozy cheetah print socks. These are so fluffy. Oh my goodness. And then we got a little Santa Christmas tree candy cane penguin, like gummy sucker. Is that what this is? That looks so fun. Okay, we got a face mask, rainbow poo. Very appropriate. I am pretty poo as well. Oh, I need a nap. But this is a face mask, so what I'm seeing is that I can put on my face mask, curl up with this blanket in those cozy socks, eating my gummies, watching whatever movie we have in here. Let's open this up and find out what movie we're watching. We are watching Jumanji! Yes, it is Jumanji, The Next Level. I don't know if you guys have seen this or not, but this movie is hilarious. This is the sequel to the original Jumanji, and yes, it's so good. I'm like cracking up just thinking back on it. So thank you so much, Ashley. I really enjoyed this box. Can't wait to watch Jumanji. And without further ado, let's get back to the vlog. That is all for today's haul. Let me know what you guys hauled in October and November, or what books you're hoping to get for Christmas. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll check in with you tomorrow. Bye, friends.